try to minimize the program. Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So, thanks all for being here in this publishing moment of our e-magazine, that is the Rainbow. Here in this virtual function, we have with us our pioneer, our torchbearer, our Honorable Principal Sir, Dr. Chitranjan Das, other dignitaries, including our Assistant Professor Kaushik Shaw, our SACT Ohin Babu. Ma'am, please, are you here, please? Are you here, RB ma'am, Atha ma'am, please, if there's anybody here, please. And a number of our staffs and our learners, that is students from the Department of English, are already here with us. You all know that the whole civilization is struggling against COVID now. We are not passing through a smooth time. Our parliamentarians are busy with their hot debating in parliament. In Tokyo, the Olympic Games are going on. And on such a moment, we have been here virtually to publish our The Rainbow, to make all enlightened and drenched with raindrops and colors. So, without much more talk, I would like to request, I would like to approach our Honorable Principal Sir, whose without continuous inspiration, this publication would not have been possible, to deliver his welcome as well as inaugural speech. Dear learners and respected guests, including our faculties, you all are cordially requested to clap while during his speech. It may be towards the end of his speech, Principal Sir will publish our magazine, that is our Rainbow. So, sir, please, it is over to you, sir.
Very good evening to everybody, those who are present here, those who are not virtually present, but they are very much with the department, with the events department is organizing, all the learned people here, including our students, our future, and the teachers of this college, and the organizers of this event, and of course the editors of the e-magazine. Very good evening to everybody. Today I was in college, and after coming to my home, I don't have any time in my hand to refresh, to get into the act, because there was a problem in college regarding the result of a student of this department, and she is unable to fill her form, sixth semester form, due to backlog in second semester. Today I approached the university authorities to address the problem, but being disappointed, I resorted to my last option. I requested our Honorable Vice Chancellor Madam to interfere into the matter and get a result for the student so that he can't lose a year. Hope for the best, I am trying. Then the students of Sanskrit department yesterday, they published their magazine, and there was a proof correction for them. So I just before this event, I was talking to the students, to the editors of the Sanskrit department e-magazine regarding proof correction. So it's a good moment to be here, to be the inaugurator of all the e-magazines, all the departments have inaugurating the departments producing for the college, or the departments are harvesting the knowledge of their students, are getting results. I just few minutes back, I got the PDF of this magazine, and I saw it. Really, it is very fantastic one. Really fantastic one. Within few seconds, within few moments, you will get the picture. You will have the e-magazine on your screen. Today, I just congratulate every writers, every contributors to this magazine. Really, they have fantastic job. The editors, I support the editors, Sadhana, Soikot, and Kishore. Maybe I may be wrong. If it is wrong, don't take me. Otherwise, don't misquote me. If it is right, then okay. Give it. Upload to me. So one thing I want to share, and today I share also with my colleagues in college, with our staff in the college. Our greatest job security is the performance. If you want to secure a job, the only security is that we have to perform. With the performance, we can secure a job. And nowadays, it is quite clear. We know the theory of Darwin, survival of the fittest. So if you want to survive, if you want to compete in the markets, in the whatever may be the market, if it is service, if it is work, if it is anything else, if it is buying and selling, whatever may be, you have to compete with others. For competition, you have to make yourself. You have to make yourself strong and strong. The quality of a person's life is in direct proportion of to their commitment to the excellence, regardless of the field they choose. Whatever the field, maybe the lowest field, maybe the highest field. In our performance, there is nothing in lowest or highest. If you perform well, you can be at the best. I just one point I want to share with you. In my higher secondary class, I have economics, history, political science, and Sanskrit. In my higher secondary class, the four subjects, and Sanskrit was my fourth subject. But as UGC guidelines says, language subject cannot be at that time. Language subject cannot be taken as fourth subject. So automatically Sanskrit was shifted to the optional subject into the three subject into the orbit of three. And political science automatically came to the fourth subject. Actually, political science was not my favorite subject. I was not the fond of the subject. So I took history, political science, history, economics, and Sanskrit. And out of these three, economics was my favorite subject. I was very much fond of the economics subject. And I really enjoyed the subject. First of all, when I started my higher secondary class, economics was very, very tough for me. Then, as the time goes by, gradually I entered into the subject and it was really fascinating me. And I enjoyed the tough subject. After completion of my higher secondary, I took economics as an honors subject. But due to some reasons, I don't want to share those reasons with you here in this platform. Part of that is due to some financial personal reasons. I wanted to shift from economics to another subject. Two subjects are there with me, that is Sanskrit and history. I was not interested to take Sanskrit. So I decided to take history as my honors, and lit science, the economics. I went to the dealing clerk of the college and requested him, please change my subject to economics history. He told me that no, it is not possible. Then after request, he has done this, he has accepted my request, and the work was done. After I have already completed 1 month or 2 months classes in economics. Then I joined in history honors. After 15 or 20 classes, 20 days of classes, I thought maybe history is not my cup of tea, because there was some there were some problems for history, and I was purely from a village, a rustic man I am. So my first step was to keep my record. The record is I have in my first division madhyamik matric, first division in higher secondary. So I want to keep the record intact. So many people, many friends and the seniors told me that you can't keep the record, you can't maintain the record in history. Maybe you can get the first division, first class. So I told that if I don't get first class, my parents would be unhappy. They told me that they will feel that after leaving the village, I am in the circle of bad friends, so I didn't get my result intact. So after a lot of consideration put into, I again decided to shift my subject from history to another subject. What is the subject? Nothing else. Sanskrit was the last subject in my combination. Again, approached the dealing assistant, dealing clerk of the college, and he also scolded me like that. You are always doing like this, continuously you are trying to change, or you are changing the subject. But I told him that yes, because I could, I am unable to carry out or carry on with this topic, so please change me. So he told me, what is the subject left with you? Sanskrit. Do you want to take Sanskrit? You are a brilliant student. Do you want to take Sanskrit? I told yes, I will take Sanskrit, because nothing, no choice is left with me. So I took Sanskrit, and the students could not imagine that after taking Sanskrit as my honor subject, I did not attend classes for 10 to 15 days. I was in depression, because a lot of friends of mine told me, advised me that it is not your cup of tea. Sanskrit is not perfect subject you choose. What can you do in Sanskrit? What can you do Sanskrit as your honor subject? Is there any future in Sanskrit? I really don't have any answer for them. But then again, I really a doubt. What can I do? Then, in the welcome ceremony of the department, when the department of Sanskrit organized a welcome ceremony for the freshers, for the honor students. In that welcome ceremony, I met a second year student brother, and he advised me many things about Sanskrit. And he now, only one friend of mine still is in good touch with me. I am also in good touch with him. That is, he is the person. He told me and also explained a lot of things before me about the Sanskrit, about the pros and cons of different subjects, the pros and cons of the future market of the different degrees. So I really was convinced by his talking, by his advice. And on that day, I decided, yes, I will continue with Sanskrit. And I really, I continued with Sanskrit. And many friends, many senior, those who were with me for different reasons, they didn't like it. They told me different things and also explained me that I choose a bad subject which has no future, which has no future prospect, etc., etc., etc. And if people could not imagine that whenever I visit my village, I kept myself aloof from them so that they can't ask me why I took Sanskrit as my subject. I just kept myself fully isolated or aloof, that I could not get in touch with them. Now after graduation, I got a chance in Shantiniketan, Vishwabharati, to have my master degree. Then I completed my doctorate degree in Shantiniketan. Now, appeared NET examination, SET examination, and qualified for both the examinations with flying colors. And also, in our College Service Commission interview, I was placed there. At that time, the selection was on the university basis, and I was selected for both Vardhaman University, the colleges under Vardhaman University, and the colleges under Calcutta University, because the Barasat University was not at that time. And in Calcutta University, I was in the second position in the panel, and in Vardhaman University, I was in the first position in the panel. But at that time, there was no counseling. So, Bonga, there was a vacancy in the Bonga College since a long time. So, I got the Bonga College, and then I approached the College Commission authorities why I got the Bonga College, because it is far away from my native place, far from my residence. They told me that Bonga, there are more students in Bonga College than the colleges in Calcutta. If you take Bonga for your profession, you will be happy, because job satisfaction is the much more, it matters most. So I decided to stay in Bonga. Now, after 8 years of service, I was also in school, also in Nimta. For 2 years, I have spent my service after qualifying in SSC exam. In Bonga, in Nimta, there was a school teacher. I was a school teacher in Nimta. Then after 1 year, 10 months, I got the lectureship in Bonga College. And after 18 years of service, I am now with you as the principal of this college. And one of my friends, he, in my Facebook, he addressed me that the first time I saw if a student of Sanskrit is now a principal of the college. Okay, now I think whatever may be our ambition, whatever may be our chosen field, if you really put our commitment, put our excellence, then we can really prosper in life. So these are the steps. Why I am talking all those things before you, because this is the publication of E-Magazine, and your examination, these are the steps where you can put your knowledge, put your experience into tests. And these are the tests. You can, through tests, you will verify yourself whether you are prepared for the future or not. So I saw have a glimpse of the E-Magazine. I said, beautiful writings are there, beautiful compositions are there, very, very good one. So I hope you, I think I am very, very much lucky to be a principal of this college where the students are so much talented, students are so much energetic also. Both in terms of knowledge and both in terms of their physical activities. So I really congratulate all of you. I really welcome all of you and give best wishes and all my best wishes and all my what can I say, all my returns, good returns to all of you for your good and secure future. One thing I want to conclude my speech in one sentence: never live till tomorrow which you can do today. Never live till tomorrow which you can do today. This is my last word to you. I hope you enjoy and you prosper and you really make us feel proud that really we are the teachers of the students of the future. Thank you. Now I am inaugurating the e-magazine, the special movement you are waiting for, and hope the head of the Department of English has already introduced that hint, given a hint that give a big upload when I inaugurate the e-magazine. The rainbow, good one. But you have given the picture of the college, the previous picture, not the updated picture. Okay, as the is the old picture of the college. Okay, old is gold. Always old will be remembered every time, everywhere. Yes. Saikat Bor Kishore Das Adhan Das. My memory is right. It is helping me. Is it visible to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And also paintings are here also. With not only the composition, not only the writings, but also the paintings of our two students. Their creativity are also here, reflected, manifested. Background scenery is very good. Editing is perfect. Good painting, good one. The camera is a good painter also. Yes, it is completed here. I welcome everybody and best wishes to everybody, and those who have not given any writing, any of their creativity here, hope in future they will have their place in this e-magazine. And I conclude here with a lot of thanks and best wishes to all those people who are involved in the publishing of this e-magazine. And again, thanks to three editors, Kishore, Sadhana, and Soikar. Over to Adhir Babu. I conclude here.
Thank you very much, sir. Actually, we have been simply charmed and deeply moved by the way you shared your spontaneous career journey, sir. Your words, that is, the greatest security of our job is to perform well. Yes, sir. We have to try for excellency. And excellency should be our prime mission, sir. And sir, your last advice, do today's work at once. Thank you, sir. We will try to follow it in every step of our academic and social and mundane life, right, sir? In the meantime, as I observed, our IQC coordinator, Dr. Atha Mallik, has joined. Welcome, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am, from the Department of English. So thank you, sir, for your pioneering speech, sir. Actually, sir, and present all, this e-magazine contains 10 pages. There are 10 poems, 6 portraits, and 2 writing associated with portrait. And as sir mentioned, there is an editorial initially by Soikat Bor, Kishore Das, and Sadhana Das. And for technical help and editing, we all from the Department of English are indebted to Chandan Babu, Chandan Vishas, one of our SACs from Bengali Department. Now, as it is the interface from our students, I would like to request, rather ask, one of our editors, Soikat Bor, to share his experience, to share his feelings here with us. Soikat, please.
Sir, I would request you to show the editorial page of the magazine on the screen, because I have some reference to mention there.
Yes, this one, Soikat, please.
Sir, a little bit above the title. Yes, sir. Sir, can I start?
Yes, what? It is your time, please.
Good evening, everyone. At first, I pay my respect to all the teachers. As you all know, that our e-magazine, which is called The Rainbow, is going to publish today. It was such a great experience for me to be a part of this great initiative. I would like to thank our Adhir sir especially, because he was the one who has always put his support and faith in us. I mean, he gave me, Kishore, Sadhana, the opportunity to lead this whole process as the editors. I have to thank our Chandan sir as well for helping us in customizing the PDF. I don't know how much I have been successful in the edit, being an editor, but I tried my best. Now coming to the point, as I have suggested the title of the magazine, so now it's time to bring out the reason behind selecting the names too. As our Adhir sir previously mentioned, rainbow, which has 7 colors in total, each one is different from the other, just like our minds. Mindsets. I mean, we all have our different thinking process, different perspectives, and different approaches toward things. This magazine is the compilation of all those different ideas. While we are customizing the PDF, I suggested an idea to our Chandan sir that we should add another metaphorical layer in the title. If we notice the title rainbow from the PDF carefully, there are 7 letters in it: R A I N B O W. Each letter has a different color, and they symbolize the 7 colors of the rainbow. I sent my editing and told this idea to Chandan sir, and he liked it. He was so kind enough to re-edit the PDF again, and I am really grateful for that. So that was the theme of our magazine. Thank you. That's it.
Thank you, Shaikat, for your precious but valuable talk regarding the editing and especially highlighting the significance behind the title, that is the rainbow. Now, from sixth semester, I would like to move towards the fourth semester. Our Krishnendu Vishwas, please, you have to share your view as the painter writer here. Please, Krishnendu Vishwas.
Thank you, sir, and good evening to everyone. First of all, I'd like to pay my respect to my honorable principal, sir, and other teachers. Also, I want to thank my respected teacher, Sri Adhir Roy. He has encouraged and guided the students and made the e-magazine a reality. Today is a special day for me and for all of us, as our e-magazine of English department, The Rainbow, is getting published today. Our e-magazine is the compilation of talents showcased by the students of our department. We all know that many colors contribute to make a proper rainbow. And just like that, the students of English honors can be compared to single patches of color as they come together to form this rainbow. In monsoon, rainbows appear after rain to fill everyone's mind with joy. Like this, we are trying to make the pandemic atmosphere joyous through this small initiative of ours. Let's hope you will all like it, and we are looking forward to it. Thank you all. That's it.
Thank you, Krishnendu, for your relevant talk to the topic, right? And your initiative. Thank you. Once again, I'm trying to move towards the 6M, and our other editor, Sadhana Das, is waiting. Please, Sadhana, come forward and share your view, share your experience, share your taste and temperament on this occasion. Sadhana, please.
I am heartily honored to be here. Good evening, everyone, respected principals and teachers, my fellow students, especially the outgoing students and the younger of our family. A very good evening to all of you. Education doesn't mean just getting a degree. Education means the overall development of the students. So, educational institutions do not only conduct one-way learning process of the students. Today, our department published our departmental e-magazine, whose name is The Rainbow. The magazine is the result of aesthetic hard work of every person in the department. I like to write poetry, but I have never tried to write English poetry before. Our HOD sir encouraged me. As editor, we know how difficult it is to publish a magazine. So I have a humble respect for all the editors. We have always learned something new by publishing this magazine from our teacher, our classmates, our junior sisters and brothers. I'm very happy to be associated with such a good work. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Sadhana, for your spontaneous and lively impression on such a great occasion. Thank you, Sadhana. Now, one of our fourth semester students, Plavon Haldar, he has contributed here as a painter, sorry, as an artist rather, sir. Now, Plavon, you are asked to say something on this great occasion before such great intellectuals, rather. Please.
Yes, sir. Thanking the principal and other teachers. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm sorry, this isn't going, taking so long, ma'am. The importance of the Rainbow or Collins magazine in my particular scheme of education can never be ignored. It is, in fact, one of these elements which goes to make higher education perfect and creative. The college magazine or the magazine called Rainbow encourages the students to reach and know things beyond our academic syllabus. It illuminates our power of thinking independently, provides a medium for self-expression and creates in a theme or a taste and beauty. Many reputed authors of our age received their basic training in artistic production through the college magazine. Also, ours is Rainbow. The spirit of the competition promoted by it proves a great incentive to the quest of knowledge. Literary magazines are a part of life. Literary magazines express the creativity of students and increase their knowledge, awakening of the beauty of compassion and humanity. Because of college magazines, nationalism is awakened or born. Above all, the charming attitude of the students is properly expressed. That's all.
Thank you, Plavon, for your talk. You know, our principal sir requested to make it short, but you know, sir, we are bound to complete our turn with two more impressions from the students. Now, I'd like to turn almost to the front page. Immediately after the editorial, there's a portrait of Queen Elizabeth. This portrait, speaking the truth, made me simply sound and deeply moved. It's a unique drawing, unique painting, sketch by Dipoman Saha. And immediately after the portrait, there is the glimpse of Elizabethan age, the golden age in English life, in many respects. So, Dipoman, please come forward and share your view with us here. Please, Dipoman.
Good evening to our great principal, sir. Good evening to all present, honorable sir, ma'am, and HODs and other college staffs. A very enchanting good evening to all. Today is the day I am feeling myself the luckiest and grateful person right now for being a little part in this e-magazine. I really cannot express my happiness by words. Now I would like to say something in brief on the regard of naming of our e-magazine. As we all know that our e-magazine's name is Rainbow. So what it depicts basically? Like, what is the inner meaning behind this name? According to me, and after doing some little research on this naming, I can say that this name, Rainbow, this is a process of waking up to the spiritual realm, which holds promises of new knowledge and truths. And it is surely a sign of hope and promise. Likewise, we can say that rainbow is the symbol of success, hope, and fortune. The various vibrant colors of rainbow indicate happiness and create a lot of excitement in the air. And here it depicts the different colors of life. The thing is, we want to be more enlightened, like a rainbow. We want others to enlighten by knowledge and love. Actually, today, being an English honors student, I am very proud on my department. It is not only because of the publishing of e-magazine, but also that we are proud to be on this special day from the beginning. Everyone done a lot of work for this e-magazine, and more than our work, our respected Adhish sir, Chandan sir, and some senior brothers and sisters who had done a lot of hard work for making this e-magazine fruitful. So a very special thanks to all of them from me, and thank you very much to our departmental head for giving me this great Ordi chance. Every word will be laced to show my gratitude towards to our English department, by whom and our dream came true today. And of course, very, very thanks to our honorable principal, sir. Without him, we could not even think about it. With this, I would like to stop my short speech right here. If I made any mistake, then please pardon me. Thank you. Thank you so much, all.
Yes, Dipuman, along with you, we all are proud here, especially in this holy evening. Yes, we are the pioneer. Time will come. Definitely our college will prosper. And the future will acknowledge your task, your achievement, that during your tenure, this magazine published for the first time. Thank you, Dipuman, for your observation. Our last speaker from the students' wing, it will be Shoikot. Sorry, our Kishore Das, one of our editors. If we concentrate towards his poem, the first two lines, as I have just observed, the sun is calling in the eastern sky. Open the mind's door and go high. Oh, what a nice expression. What a nice optimism. Sir, little letter. Yes. No, sir. Yes. The sun is calling in the eastern sky. Open the mind's door and go high. Yes. Let our motto be, after Kishore's writing, open the mind's door and go high. And my request, Kishore, please come forward and share your talks with us in front of our principal, sir, our respected dignitaries, and your brothers and sisters. Please, Kishore, come and say something.
Thanks a lot, sir. Good evening, all. In this sweet evening, our honorable principal, sir, has just published our English departmental magazine. In this event, here present our honorable principal, sir, our all departmental professors and college staff, I greet everyone to respect with respect and my sincere love from the bottom of my heart for the seniors, my classmates, and my juniors. Today, a little effort of the English department has been successful through the publication of the magazine The Rainbow. First of all, I would like to thank our honorable principal sir for giving us the opportunity to express these seven colors in a line. Then I would like to thank my departmental head, our honorable professor, Mr. Adhir Roy, for his inspiration and guidance. I thank our departmental professors and our Bengali departmental professor, especially Mr. Chandan Bishwas Mahashoy, for giving life to our lines on the pages. For this pandemic situation, we are far from our beloved college and parents like professors. Online is the only way to communicate. Today, we are extremely happy because our seven colors spread through the wireless screen. This is the first English rainbow in the sky of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Shatobarshiki Mahavidyalaya. And I believe that every year the rainbow will shine brighter in the sky of our college through our juniors. So I think today's small effort will be immortal in the sky of the future. So again, I thank our honorable principal sir, our all departmental professors, and thank you all.
Thank you, Kishore. You are always right. I can say you that be our thoughts, BRR in future, Kishore. Your words, that is the first English rainbow in the sky of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Shatobarshiki Mahavidyalaya, right? It is a proud and a real expression from the Department of English. Thank you. Actually, sir, I don't know the norms of some of such occasions, of such functions. Maybe I am going to break the norms. Yes, before giving our vote of thanks, which will be given by Rakesh Sarkar, our departmental SACT. Sir, I would like to approach you, our principal, sir. Please say something in response to these emotions by our six students. Sir, please.
I am really mesmerized. It is a good expression by all the students. They share their experience in such a way that it is really very heart-touching, and I really, from the core of my heart, I greet them and I congratulate them. Their expression of their feelings, their presentation skills, and their attitude to the event, really fantastic. First time I got the opportunity to have the experience of their qualities, of their innovatives, their innovations and creativity, and their skills also. I was just thinking about the lines of Kishore. The sun is calling in the eastern sky and open the mind's door and go high. And the word, the line used by him, the first rainbow, the English departmental rainbow in the sky of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Shatobarshiki Mahavidyalaya. I clapped. I just unmuted and clapped on this word. Really, it is fantastic, and they hope, I hope, they will make us proud in future. I am really spellbound. What can I say? I have lot of, not only greetings, I have blessings upon them. So they have expressed, all they have expressed in such a way, the selection of words and selection of sentences, really it is very creative and innovative. I think they're well prepared for the future, not for this event, for the future. Hope all the best, all of you, good future for you. And I just said in my speech, the greatest job security is your performance. So your performance, of course, will secure you in future, secure a life, you secure a future, and also make us proud for you that you are all our students. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you once again, sir, for your inspirational response to our students. Okay. We are already towards the end of our function today, that is this inaugural function of our departmental e-magazine, that is the Rainbow. Now it is time for vote of thanks. And I would like to ask our SACT Rakesh Sarkar for giving the vote of thanks. Rakesh Sarkar, over to you, please.
Thank you, Professor Adhir Roy, head of the English department of our college. On behalf of the English department, I would like to thank our mentor and pioneer, Honorable Principal Sir, Dr. Chittaranjan Das. I would also like to thank our Honorable IQAC Coordinator Madam, Dr. Ata Mollik. We are really grateful to Professor Chandan Bishas for technical support to arrange this program. Once again, thank you all the other staff, participants, listeners, and dear students. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Rakesh Babu. And sir, may we conclude, sir, with this note? Please, sir.
Yeah, of course, conclude. আমি একটা কথা বাংলায় বলতে চাইছি যে একটা কথা আমি পড়েছি কোথায় এটা মনে পড়ছে না, যদি আমাদের দৃষ্টি এক বছরের জন্য হয় তাহলে ফুল ফোটান, গাছে ফুল তৈরি করুন, যদি আমাদের দৃষ্টি 10 বছরের জন্য হয় তাহলে গাছ লাগান, যদি আমাদের দৃষ্টি অনন্তকালের জন্য হয় তাহলে মানুষ তৈরি করুন। Really, we are doing that. We are not looking for 1 year, we are not looking for 10 years, we are looking for eternity. That is why we are cultivating people, we are cultivating our human resources. And life has given a chance to us to work hard. And that is the best gift to us by life. Thank you. We are really cultivating the people.
Thank you, sir. So, with this note, I would like to conclude our program today. And